Hey Flosstube, it is Michelle from Made by Michelle McGraw, and this is Flosstube number 32. So welcome to everybody returning. Thank you so much for spending time with me. And if you're new here and you like what you see, like and subscribe. And leave me a comment and join in. I am Made by Michelle McGraw on Instagram, and I do post a lot on there and interact, and it's one of the things that I really, really like. I do read all the comments that are posted on here, and I always try to respond and try to interact, because that's the best part of Flosstube for me, is you guys, is making friends and stitching with friends. So thank you for that. I'm going to jump in. I have stuff everywhere. I am here early this week. I have some finishes, and I have some things that I've been working on, and I thought I'm just going to jump in and share them. So I'm back early. So anyhow, and just FYI, so I wear this shirt a lot. I have 5 of them, just to clarify. So yeah, I have 5 of the exact same shirt, because it is, the material of the shirt is really thin, and it has a very flowing design to it, I guess. And if you don't know this, random Michelle facts, I wear leggings every day of my life. If I have to put on real pants, I'm not going there, just so you know. So something goes on that I have to wear real pants to, I'm not gonna be there. I'm gonna wear leggings, just for everybody to be prepared. That's what it's gonna be. So anything that I can find that's a flowy top, because you have to cover up the butt. Like, I'm not like having my butt hang out, but if I have something that's like flowing and the material is good in the summertime, I tend to wear it a lot. So I ended up loving this shirt that I got. I actually got it off of QVC. It's no longer available because I've gone back for more. No longer available. I have it in white and pink as well. And it is like the best shirt, like flowing and all. So like, I laugh, my girlfriends laugh at me, because when we go to Disney, I bring multiples of this shirt. And my girlfriend's like, you can't do that. Like, you'll be wearing the same thing in all of our pictures. And I'm like, it's what I brought. Because it's so flowing. Like, we have gone, when it's hot, you know, and you get hot at Disney, and this is flowing and comfortable, and so I wear it. So just in case you ever wanted to know, 1, I don't wear pants, and 2, I don't rewear my shirts that often. I just have multiples of some. I wish it was a plain black one, because then you would just be like, oh, she has a black shirt on, but it has writing on it, and it says, cool people smile, which annoys me when I wear it to work, and then one of the witty truck drivers are like, oh, you're not smiling. And I'm like, it's 7:30 in the morning, dude. I'm like 1 sip into my coffee. Move it along. Move along. Yeah, that's me. No, I'm not a morning person. That's another random fact about Michelle that nobody asked for, just so you know. Not a morning person. Okay, so this week, we'll actually talk about stitching stuff. This week I worked on reorganizing the way I track my projects. So I got this idea halfway from Janet Jabber. Hey Janet. And kind of adapting it. So she has a little piece of paper that she, has, I think, in her project bags, and she takes it out and it has all of the details on it for that project. I did the same thing, but I used to use my Canva journal, which is from Catherine Pooler. And I love these, and they're a bullet journal type journal. I love the paper. I love the fact that it writes really smooth, and I used to do it. The problem is now that I have so many WIPs, I put my projects in the front part of the book and then put my Flosstube notes and stuff that I wanted to talk about in the back of the book, and they're meeting too quickly. And for me, I have so many WIPs because it's who I am. I start all the things. like if I get another book, I'm literally rewriting half the book into the book because I haven't finished it. Does that make sense? So I didn't think that that was a good idea. So I kept thinking, I still like to put my floss tube notes in the book. But for my projects, I kind of needed something else that was easier to add to and take away from. If I mess up in this book, I have to rip it out, rip the page out. And sometimes there's writing on the back of the page. And the great thing, if you don't know about a bullet journal, her journals are the same way. So she has a spot on the front that has table of contents, and then the pages are numbered. So like you could use this numbering system and use it on the front of your book and you would have your pages numbered. I hope that showed the right way for you guys. It doesn't for me. So anyhow, there's numbers on the bottom of the page. If you didn't read that correctly, there's numbers there. That number was 107, not 701, in case it was reading backwards. But I love her notebooks, but I needed something that was a little easier just for my projects. So I got to thinking, what system would work great for me? I kind of liked, I kind of liked Janet's card system. And I don't know if she's ever showed the front of her cards. I'm assuming it's like a little piece of paper. And I assume that when Janet is done with the project, if you don't watch Janet Jabber, go watch her. She's awesome. I'm assuming when she's done with the project, she just saves those little cards, but maybe she doesn't. I don't know. I kind of like them because sometimes I go back to a project or I want to restitch a project. I don't restitch often, but I have. And so I would want to know like, well, what did I use before? And I could maybe guess by looking at it, but if it's a gift that I've given away, then I couldn't look at it again. So I want to keep the cards. So I ended up coming up with a system and I've actually used it and it's working fantastic. So I'm going to show it to you first. So I came up with my card system. Now this is a bigger card file than most people might need, but as you can see, I have a, let me see if I can show this, divider here. So I have like the front part is working. These are spare cards back here. This is a file that I can grow into, that I can keep for the duration of my cross-stitching life. So I got this on Amazon and they had this, this is metal with a plastic top. And I had this, you could get different colors and I liked the little teal. I would call that teal, I guess. So let me show you, they are alphabetized what I do. So I have the ABC card dividers. Let me show that better up close. They're just plastic card dividers. And I chose to do a 5x7. So the dividers are, I think they're 5x8. They're slightly bigger, which is what you want. And I did my cards on 5x8. So I'm gonna take where I have filed one. Let me do a different one. Okay. So let me show you one with notes on it. Oh, here we go. This is a good one that has a lot of notes on it. Okay, so under A, I have a card that has my project, Alpaca Farm, and then who's it's by. I have my start date, my fabric that I used, and then I use any notes. I also have notes on the back. These are my floss conversions that I'm using. So this is what the pattern called for. This is what I'm actually using. And this way, when I go back to this project, I can look and say, oh, for 3371, I'm using 3371. For DMC 300, I'm using Gentle Arts Mulberry. So I have that right there. I have all my notes, anything that I would write about that project, and I have plenty of room. If I decide that I need more room, I can take another blank card and staple them together. And then I can easily have my whole project together. So I can add to this. I can take this card to my table when I cross stitch. This is where I cross stitch, not this chair. This is the light, but I have an, you can't see it in the thing. I have an Ott light that hangs over this area. So my chair would be right down in there. So I have a fold-up table that I have in front of me, and I can put the card that I'm working on right on the table, doesn't take up much room, and I can know. So then my dilemma was, well, how was I going to know what projects I worked on if I didn't write them down in my notebook? Because that's what I do. I would write down in my notebook what projects I worked on. So when I did a Flosstube, I can say, I worked on this, this, and this. So my easy answer was, I take my cards that I worked on for the week and I put them in front of the card file. So when I do a Flosstube, I just pull them out. So I do have numbers on here where I numbered them. So this was WIP number 55 in the year 2020. Yeah. Number 55. I have more than that. We'll just let that go. Now, some of those might be done in there, but they might not be. Also, what I found, I thought, well, if I want to hold on to these, let me find one that I have finished so I can show you that. It's embarrassing when you can't find one you've finished. Here's one, In the Seas. Okay, so this is Christmas Tree Farm by Prairie Schooler. And I started this on July 8th, 2019. I have my fabric where I used oaken. I have that I used a 3-inch border. I used called for 2 strands, and I had my finish date of August 10th, 2019. Then I write finished across it. So I know that this card is finished. I keep this towards the back part of that alphabetical letter. So I would file Christmas Tree Farm under C. I keep it under the back part. My active projects are in the front. I'm gonna see how that works. I may pull them out and put them all towards the back. For right now, it's working. It's not a big deal. So that has worked really well. The great thing about this is this is just cardstock. And you can see I made extra 5x7 cards that I cut them with my trimmer. And I had cardstock. I make cards and I make scrapbooks, and I don't do it as much anymore because I'm cross-stitching all the time. I've always cross-stitched. I've always had a project going, but I just do it more so in the last several years. but I have tons of cardstock on my shelves. So when I was pulling for this, I kept thinking, oh my gosh, I'm taking so much floss or so much cardstock. This is gonna like dwindle my cardstock, my 8.5x11 cardstock. It didn't. Sad to say, it did not. But I had this on file. So like really, the only thing I needed was the cardstock or the card index file holder. I maybe could have used something that I had. I liked this one when I found it. It was under, I think it was $20 or under. And I thought, okay, this will be good. I could have made the dividers, the little alphabetic dividers. I could also made those with cardstock. I didn't, I just ordered them. I think those were like $4 for the pack. So I was just like, I'm just gonna order them and be done. But I use this in my office to do billing for dumpsters that we have, because every dumpster is different based on the location and jobs. And I might bill one company 4 bills that week for different jobs, because I have to break it out per job. And I have little note cards, and it's a system that's worked for me for years that keeps it organized and keeps all of my pricing. So I knew that system kind of worked, and I thought, well, let me try it for cross stitching. And so far I love it. And I love using stuff that I already have. So I would love to say I used it all up. I did not use it all up. Anyhow, so if you think that is a system that might work for you, you might want to try it. It definitely can be done not with a fancy card holder. You could use a shoebox. I use a plastic shoebox at my office. You could use a basket. You could use a lot of different things, you know, just anything that you had laying around. You could use a box if you wanted to. You could use anything you had laying around to make the actual card file. And then most of us were other crafters at one time, you might have cardstock laying around. You just cut it down. I have tons of scraps left over, but I use scraps a lot of times. I write my DMC lists on them to take to the store because I can find them in my pocketbook. So I don't lose them. I also use them for grocery lists. We put them on the refrigerator, and so my boys write like anything that they need from the grocery store. So when I ordered from the grocery store, I pulled a list off there. So those kind of little scraps that I have, I use them all the time. So that will get used. And yes, I know it's cardstock, but for me, it's like I'm looking at my refrigerator and there's a piece of cardstock scrap on my refrigerator now with a list on it. It's what we do because it's, my boys notice it, if that makes sense. I don't know if that makes sense. They might not notice just a plain piece of paper up there. Knowing them, they would not. So this colored piece, they're like, oh, the grocery list. Let me write down, I used all of the whatever, and they write it down. Okay, so that was an idea for anybody who's stuck. If you want to keep track of your projects, if you want to keep track, you could even put like the date that you stitched on your projects. I know some people do that. I do not. But I mean, maybe that's something that I would like to track in the future, and I could totally do that. So anyhow, that is what I came up with. So I do want to do, before I get too far into it, I want to do giveaways from last time, cause I had quite a few, and then I will do the giveaway for this week. I have three, and then we'll go into whips. Okay. So I did the random generator with the keywords that you guys were to use for each pattern. And let me pull up the right pattern. Okay, so the first one is To the Beach from Hands On Designs, Stars in the Sky, this giveaway. And this goes to, there was 21 people that entered into this one. And Amy Omak. M-O-A-K. I'm probably killing your last name, and I'm so sorry, Amy. But Amy, you won. So maybe that cancels it out that I say your last name wrong. I do not do that on purpose. I will tell you that. So I have three boys. All three of my boys are dyslexic. I have found through the journey with them that I am dyslexic as well. I am dyslexic when things are done orally to written. That doesn't sound like, that sounds weird, but if, like, I hate when people at my office call and give me a credit card over the phone because I transpose numbers. It's just what I do. So I am paranoid because I know that I do it, and I have to take it very slowly, and I have to ask them to repeat it, and I have to make sure that I'm saying it in my head as I'm writing it so that I don't do it. But I found these little things that I do that I had no idea that I have these characteristics that my children got, that they have it definitely more than me, but I see the characteristics in myself. And, you know, apple tree. So I always said it came from my husband, and I think it's me. Anyhow, so if I kill your name, I do not do it intentionally, just so you know. I had a really sweet, sweet comment from April, which last week I talked about the Through the Stone sampler that she has from Crown Street Cottage on Etsy. And she said, I said her name wrong and I spelled it wrong. And I literally was looking at the piece of paper when I spelled her name. I was looking at it and I said it wrong. So sorry, April. She was very sweet. She was very understanding. And she laughed about it. And I'm like, yeah, kind of dyslexic in that manner. So if I kill your name, I'm very sorry. I don't mean to. Okay. Amy, contact me. My email is madebymichellemcgraw@gmail.com. Or you can send me a message on Instagram at, my Instagram is madebymichellemcgraw. Michelle is two L's. Either way, send me your address, send me your full name, and send me the chart that you won. I have it wrote down, but I triple confirm as I'm mailing it out. So if I see your comment and it says that, and I can see that I have it in my hand, and that's what I left the house that morning before I got to my office and thought Amy's getting the stars pattern, I triple check it so I make sure I send the right chart to the right person. So it just helps. So send me a message on there. Congratulations, Amy. Let's move on. Okay, so the next one I had wrote down was the French Country Ornaments from JBW Designs. Really cute. And there was 27 entries into this, and Beth Walker won. So Beth, send me a message. Congratulations. Okay, flags is next. And this is learn your ABCs, and I said to say flags. There were 6 entries, and I am going to kill your name. I am so sorry, Michelle. Michelle Civiello? C-I-V-I-T-E-L-L-O. Michelle, send me a message. Congratulations. Okay, the next one is Ro, and that's actually the pattern name, Ro. And Lynch Helton, L-Y-N-C-H, Lynch Helton, send me a message. There was 12 entries. Congratulations. Okay, the next one is Refuse to Sink, and there was 9 entries, and it's Suzanne Reardon, R-E-A-R-D-O-N. Congratulations, Suzanne. Send me a message. Okay, and the last and final is the Peace Snowflake from Stony Creek. And there was 13 entries, and Sherry Eccles, E-C-H-O-L-S. Eccles? I think. Contact me if I didn't say your name right. I'm so sorry. But congratulations to all the winners. So the biggest thing that I took away from that was, because I had so many patterns last week, which was unusual because normally I have one. I don't really pay attention to how many entries there are because I have one. So I draw it, I look at the name, and I'm done. This time I was looking and I was like, oh, there's 27 entries for this one. Oh, there's 21, you know, but there were some that only had 6, 9, 13. Those are really good odds. So leave me a message, say the keywords in your message. Don't say giveaway. You can literally make a comment and put the word at the end of the comment. You can literally, your comment can just be the word. It's okay. I'm not offended. If that's all you have time to do, that's okay. So enter, because there's a good chance you'll win. Okay, this week I went through, these are all from Stash and things that either I have stitched or I'm not going to stitch. These are all new patterns I have not stitched. When I get a pattern, I do not generally stitch off of the pattern. Some of my old patterns I did. Generally, I do not stitch off the pattern. I make a working copy of it, mainly because I would like to pass the pattern on to other people when I'm done stitching. I may pass it on to my sister. I may pass it on to a friend. I may do it as a giveaway. I don't want to mark up my patterns. I have a copier at home because of our business. I have a copier at my office. It is very easy for me to make a copy of the pattern. I do not give away my working copy, just so you know, and I will not give away the pattern until I'm done working on it. When I'm done with that pattern, that working copy either is stuck in the pattern, so it goes with the pattern. So like maybe I would give it to my sister and I might give her my working copy as well with the pattern. So she's not going to stitch off the pattern. She's going to stitch off the working copy, but she has both of them. I did not keep them. Or I just throw my working copy away because it's so destroyed by the time I'm done with it, you know, from folding it and putting it in bags and that kind of stuff. So that's what I do. So even though these are from my stash, they do not have marks in them. I will tell you, if I have a pattern, especially a very desirable pattern, I don't know that I have any of those, but if I have a desirable pattern that I'm giving away and it has a mark in it, I will tell you. So anyhow, this is a lot of talking, very talking today. Anyhow, I wanted to give these patterns away because these are fall from my stash. So this is called Pumpkin Brew. It's a little mini. This is 35 by 34 stitches. Really cute, would make a quick little Halloween ornament. And if you would like Pumpkin Brew, you are going to say the word, let me just make sure because I wrote it down, pumpkin. That's what's gonna be in your pumpkin. Okay, the next one is Thanksgiving Hoodies. That name cracks me up. Okay, this is really cute for Thanksgiving. The little birds, the pumpkins, some cute little ones that you could do in minis, or you could do it as a whole one, whichever. And if you're interested in this pattern, you're going to put hooties in your comment. H-O-O-T-I-E-S. Hooties. The keyword today, hooties. You also can enter in multiples. So when I do the random generator, I put in each word individually, and I don't disqualify you. It's possible that if I didn't have a lot of entries or the random generator, it could pick the same winner for two patterns because they put in both names. It could happen. It hasn't yet, but it could. Okay, the last one is from Spider and Bones from the Drawn Thread. Really cute. And you're going to say bones in your comment. So this one I actually bought to stitch, and I wanted to stitch it. And I actually ended up buying this as a finished flat fold from my local L&S. They were clearancing out some finishes. They have like a little section in the back of their store at Rock Hill. It's Stitch and Frame, and in Rock Hill, South Carolina. And they always have like a little section in the back that has a basket that is 25, 50, and 75 off. And you go through the basket. Those are charts. Around those charts up on the wall are finishes that she is selling. I've gotten some finishes there for cheaper than I could buy the chart, buy the material, buy the fabric, and have it finished. So when I found this, I didn't realize that I already had this pattern. But I already have it. I bought it. It was a little flat fold, really cute. And I thought, I'll give it away to a viewer. So those are my three giveaways. Okay, now that we got that done, okie dokie. Now I'm going to go through, I have whips and haul. So my first one that I'm gonna do is Away We Ride from Blackbird Design. And if you remember, I showed this last time, and I was not happy with my margin that I had on my fabric. I had less than an inch in one area to do framing. This is something, if you're not familiar with the chart, Away We Ride from Blackbird Design. You can see my working copies are in here. So I did a couple of things. One, I restarted it. It just made me anxious to continue to put work into something. And I think Rock Hill does a fantastic job of framing my stuff when I want it framed. But less than an inch is pushing the envelope, even for a good framer. And I thought, you know what? I just don't like that option. I'm going to restart it. And I literally had like this little bit and like a little bit in here. That was it. So to me, it was more important to restart it and to do it the right way versus... It just, and some people would be fine with that less than an inch, and people would say you could totally, you know, lace it. Sorry, my ankle is itchy. I have a mosquito bite. You could totally lace it and you'll be fine. I just, it made me anxious. And I was like, you know what? I'm regretting every time I go to stitch on this, and I'm going to fix it now. So I did restart it. Here is my start. It's not impressive, but let me put something behind it. Let me put the pattern behind it. Okay. So I restarted this, and this is restarted on 22 count from Silk Weavers. It did not have a name. Let me show you the whole fabric. Let me make sure I didn't. No, here's my needle. Okay. So this is what I would consider a murky-esque fabric. I love, as you guys know, my favorite fabric is Murky from Picture This Plus. And to me, this was very, very similar. But I liked the fact that it was 22 count. So this is teeny, teeny, tiny. Don't know if you can realize that, but it's tiny compared to my last start. I really, really like Blackbird's, like if you'll notice, like one color starts the frame and you stitch the darker color here and then it flip-flops. Down here, the frame is the darker color and then the little flower is. And it's really interesting to stitch, but I was having issues stitching on it originally. And that part is, it's not confusing because the symbols are very clear, but it just was a pain in the butt. And then I realized my pattern, my working copy was not the best. I had just made a copy of it. So I'm going to show you a page. I'm not going to show you all of the pattern, but I'm going to show you a piece of it to show you what I did. So as you can see, this is only a little bit of this up here. I blew it up on my working copy. And I do that sometimes, but I don't know if people know to do that on their working copies. I blew mine up. Now you have to make sure when you enlarge your copy that you make sure you catch everything, because obviously, like, just showing you those two strips, I would need to move my pattern over to get more of it. My pattern over so I could copy more of it because I'm enlarging it. Enlarging the pattern helped so much. So if you are struggling with a pattern, and this isn't small, this pattern really isn't printed small. It's just the fact that you're switching back and forth between those two colors in those areas, that blowing it up just made it 100% easier for me. So if that's something you struggle with, maybe take it and go blow up your copy. And I generally blow mine up to like 125 or 130. And that seems to be enough for me most times. And then I can see it better, and it just makes it easier to work with. So if that is something that you struggle with, blow up your copy and see if it helps. Okay. The next thing I want to show, I don't think I showed this last time because I don't think I was done. So I want to show I have a finish on Chewy and the Porg. Isn't he cute? This is from Good Morning Maui, and I am just simply dividing them up into two. This is a 14 count fabric, and you can see my hoop line because I didn't iron it. This is a 5-inch hoop. So you can see that kind of gives you a reference point. So it makes a decent size ornament when I do it on 14 count. And I do two people. So the Porg is a little small because he's a Porg, obviously, but you get the point. So I do two of these to make a one. I am starting on, I'm trying to find my bag with this, and I thought I brought it over here, but maybe I didn't. Okay, the next one I'm doing is another one from Good Morning Maui. This one is the Last Jedi pattern, and I'm doing just the Star Wars pattern, and I'm doing Bubba Fett and a Stormtrooper. That was what my oldest requested for his ornament. So that's the next one I'm doing. So that is done. I will probably work on his tomorrow when I'm at work, because I do a opening shift tomorrow and I work all day on Fridays. So I always take something to stitch with me. So I do have to find that bag so it can go in my to-go bag. I don't know what I did with it. I swear I brought it up here, but apparently not. Okay, the next one that I have on my list is a new start, because that's what I do. By the way, that was not me. That's one of my dogs snorting underneath my feet. In case you heard that, that's dog snorting. Okay, so this is another thing that I do. So do you see how big this bag is? It clearly did not come with this pattern. The sampler companies have cellophane pattern on their patterns, and they're not really great to like put back in. So I like to put the pattern in a plastic bag that, like, this probably had fabric in it or other charts, like a combination of charts with an order, and I have it and I saved it. The other thing these bags are good for is I printed off the Adam family, house off of Etsy. I haven't started it yet, but that pattern is over 100 pages. It fits really good in one of these big bags. So if you have a really, really large PDF pattern, like maybe a Hade that you printed off and you don't know kind of how to store it without it getting messy, save some of these from your orders and stick them in there. So anyhow, that's really long today, random. All right, so this is the sampler company. This is called Over the Hill. I think I showed this as stash last time, and it says King George commands and we obey over the hill and far away. And then it has a Latin, what I think is a Latin phrase, and it says fortune comes for the brave. And it tells you in the pattern what that Latin says. I really, really, really like her patterns. This is Brenda Keys, the sampler company. I really enjoyed stitching on this. I stitched on it for, I think, 2 days. Let me get something behind it so it doesn't. And I love it. So I have the church pretty much built. I need to add the grass. I am starting up here with the village. There is a village up here in the distance. I don't know if you can see it. And it's kind of faded. You stitch it over one strand. So I'm starting that part of it up here. I'm kind of working a little bit up here. Here's the skyline for that. Also why I'm working the grass. So this is a bigger sampler. I really like it. I've really enjoyed her patterns. I mean, she has so much in her patterns. If you've never had one of her patterns, like there's a whole page about where the sampler motifs and what they mean. Really cute. So anyhow, that is my Over the Hill sampler. It is a very nice stitch. Let's see if I can tell you what I stitched it on. I am using 28 count vintage linen. That was the only information that I had. It was a piece from my stash. But there's my start. So I am obsessed with her samplers, and you will see that in just a little bit, because when I started this and I realized how much I really loved the pattern and I just loved the whole aspect of everything, I ordered some more and they already come in. So I will share those with you. Hold on, I don't want to get fabric stuck in the bag. Oh, just sit down, baby. I have dogs wandering, and that generally means they're gonna bark at something, and I hope not. Okay, so I did not have super amount of work done on this one, but I did get some work done. Let me show you the pattern. So I am working on, this is not the same Addams Family that I was talking about earlier. The other one is like a big house with all different rooms in it, which I hope to start very, very soon. I have it all kitted up, I think, except for one color. And I just really like it. So I love the Addams Family. I'm not a huge fan of the older show. I didn't watch it. I mean, I saw it as a kid, but I didn't watch it. It was a little bit before me in watching. So I think I was watching reruns of it. But I love the movie remakes. They are funny, quirky. I love the house with haunted, with passages. I love any of that kind of stuff. So, all right. So this is my Addams Family. And I am doing each thing individually for my dough bowl for Halloween. So if you remember from before, I have already done Morticia. So she is finished. And I am stitching this on 14 count prank from Picture This Plus. So that is Morticia. After Morticia comes the mansion. And so I started on that, and this is my progress. So it's coming along. I think I worked one night on this. It's a fun stitch. I like that. It's a little mini one. It's fun. And I will finish those into mini pillows for my dough bowl when I get done. Okay, now the next whip that I'm gonna show you is Yonder from Hello from Liz Matthews. I am doing this as a sow with Janet Jabber, and it's hashtag YonderSow, and I have seen some people joining us. Thank you. I enjoy, the more the merrier. That's my motto. So let me take this out of the hoop because I am stitching this one on 25 count vintage country mocha. And let me put a piece of paper behind it just in case. And I did get more work done. So I did the brown lines across and I filled more in on the grass on the bottom. I worked on this on Monday, just for a little while I had an appointment. So I got a little bit done. I love this. This is a fun stitch. I mean, it's really fun. And I'm gonna be honest with you, I haven't pushed for this project to be done or really like pushed because I just enjoy stitching on it. It's a fun stitch. I really like the Lugana fabric. I've been obsessed with that lately. And I just enjoy it. So I like to stitch just a little bit on it and put it down and it's just been fun. But yeah, I've gotten some work done on it this week. I have this in my equipment bag that I made because we are in the construction business. And I did some quilting. You can see it a little bit here on the bag. So yeah, that was just a fun print that I had. And it has vehicles on the inside. So, all right. The next one. Hey, I found my Star Wars bag. It's here. I found it. I knew I brought it over here. Okay, I need to put that pattern back in there just in case. I have all of my patterns. I showed this in my Flosstube before. I have a lot of Good Morning Maui patterns in here that I pull from. I stitch on them. I have one more that I'm going to be stitching, and then this will go on the shelf. I will keep this kitted up because there are other ones I still want to do, but I'm going to be done with it for this year. So I will keep it still in this bag. Okay, I have a hair in my mouth. Yeah, it happens. Okay, this next one, I am so excited to show you because I have held to my thing of, so I am talking on Janet Jabber this whole video this time. So Janet, this is like a fangirl video for you. So Janet does a thing where she stitches on a project for 30 minutes a day and she just gets progress done on them. So I wanted to do something similar. I have been struggling to finish Visit Mordor from Country Magic Stitch. Now, I love this pattern. There's absolutely nothing wrong with the pattern. I love it. I love the purples. I love the oranges. I don't know why. It's dragging for me, and I needed to get over that hump. I needed to just finish this. So as I showed you guys last time, I had page 3 done. I finished page 3. I was so excited. So I have page 4 in my hoop. It is this section, and this is what I've gotten done. So I still have more to do, obviously, but as you can see, it's starting to fill in. I do color completion on this because it is an easy pattern to do color completion. So I am now on one symbol. I will bring it all the way down, and that's kind of how I work on this. So I haven't done 30 minutes every single day, but I have done 30 minutes maybe every other day, and it is making a progress. So I'm going to go ahead and say, I think that that might be a new thing that I do, that I pick one project per week after I get this one done, because this one's getting done, or one project per until completion, and I work on it 30 minutes each day or every other day. Until I get it done. And I really like the fact that it's just 30 minutes. And so I go over to my stitching chair and I'm like, oh, I got to go do my homework. That's kind of what I say to myself. Let me go do my 30 minutes. And I go over there and I pull it out and I stitch on it, and it's making progress just in 30 minutes. So Janet, thank you so much for that. And it's working for me. Okay. I've got one more to show you before I show you haul. And some of these are a finish. So I have 3 finishes. Okay, so I am working on Farm Girl Fall from Lori Holt, Be In My Bonnet. And as you can see, she made hers into a pillow. That's really cute. I am making mine into mini pillows for my dough bowl for the fall. So I am obsessed with my dough bowl, if you guys haven't noticed. So I want to like stitch all of the things for my dough bowl. Oh, the sun's coming way out. I have a hard time with the sun when it's in this room, but anyhow, so I am dividing each motif up into a separate pillow. I also have in the same bag, I have the stitch cards from Lori Holt, the Christmas one that's similar to this. There's a quilt one that's similar to this and something else. And I might take the quilt one and like change it for use some of these fall colors on it and do a couple of them to put in there so I can fill my dough bowl. These do not take long. They are, each motif is 30 by 30. So they don't take long. I am stitching these per the instructions on 10 count fabric. Now, I brought some of that over here. I have never, let me see if I can find it. Yes, here it is. I got this from Fat Quarter Shop, and it is Vintage Cloth by Lori Holt of Be In My Bonnet. It's 10 count even weave, and it's 18 by 18 inch fabric is what the label says. And I bought it because she talked about doing it on these, which is what she did her pillow on. Now, I expected this to be stiff because it's 10 count. It's not going to be great, right? I actually really like this. Now, I don't know that I'm going to stitch tons and tons of things on 10 count, but for my dough bowl, these make it bigger. So I normally stitch at least 14 count, and this goes a little bit above that. So it's helping make them a good size, and I like that. So I have several packs of these. I just cut them up to do them. And I will show you my progress. So I have done the acorn. I love that. They all have like quilting type motifs to them. So I really like that. And as you can see, I just cut it up. If you can see how this is draping, it is soft material. So if you've thought about buying this from Fat Quarter Shop, but you didn't quite know, and it has like a little bit of a silky feel. So I actually really, really like this material. I would recommend this material, especially if you're doing stuff for smalls. There is the leaf. And this is the crow, which I love. So I am working on the next one. So I have done all of the ones atop, across the top, and I am working on this quilt motif. Now, I will tell you, I did not like the green and the blue and the pink together. It just didn't jive for me. I didn't like it. So I'm just using the same, I'm using colors from the floss, and I'm doing a different one. So I'm going to do red, dark gray, teal, and yellow in here. And you can see my progress. So this is a 7-inch hoop. So that kind of gives you a little bit of reference on how big they are. So they do make them a little bit bigger. Let me just, these are not exactly the same pattern. But these were my other dough bowls. So as you can see, these are gonna be a little bit bigger, which I really, really like. Because these are small. I love these little things that I have in my dough bowl that I did. This is heart strength samplery mini motifs, mini fobs. And I did the barnyard ones. But as you can see, like these are gonna be bigger, and I like that. So I've been working away on these, and these have been really fun. She has a lot of patterns, and I think most of them, if you look at the Lori Holt ones that are kind of these quilt ones, she said it on a floss tube, they are all the same size. So like her Christmas ones are the same size, the quilt things are the same size. I didn't bring that bag over here, so I don't have it to show you. I will try to show it to you next time, all the different options there are. Fat Quarter Shop, really cute. Material is from Fat Quarter Shop as well. I'm not sponsored by them. Fat Quarter Shop, if you want to sponsor me, I like your stuff. But anyhow, they're really cute. So I love to pass on stuff that I like to use. So there you go. Regardless if they're sponsored or not. Okay. So I have some haul, And then I have some kitted projects and I'm trying to decide which one I'm going to start next. So I will bring those up when I come back and we'll talk about those. Some people don't like to see haul. If you're not interested in haul, I'm not going to say anything else interesting other than haul. And I'll say, see you guys later. But if you like haul, stick around because I bought tons of the Sampler Company Designs by Brenda Keys patterns. Now I have to look. Okay, this is called Sampler Houses. I think they are so cute. And I don't know how I would do it yet. I thought about taking them and doing them for my dough bowl because I think those little houses would be so cute. But I don't know. I might do it as a sampler. Who knows? This one is Plant Wisdom Sampler. Trying to get, there's a glare. There you go. So you see a pattern. I liked it. I went and bought more. This is Country House Sampler. There we go, I think. By the way, if you can hear the dog snoring underneath the table, I'm not sure which one it is. There's three. It's a little out of hand here. Town and Country Sampler. I do wish her pictures were bigger on the front because they are fantastic. A sampler story. Lots of little boxes. My idea for this one was to do these for my dough bowl. I don't know if I will or not. I don't know. There's so many good ones on here. So maybe it would be really fun. This one is some mini samplers, and this is called Biblical Minis. It's Adam and Eve, Faith, Hope, and Charity, The Spies from Canaan, and Noah's Ark. So try to get close as I can for those. They are really hard to see. But the pattern name is Biblical Miniatures. And this is sweet humility sampler. It should be humid sampler because it's humid in the South. Love it. This is Puritan Sampler. I love that border on that one. And now I think there's two dogs snoring. The Huntsman Sampler. I really, really, really like this one. That guy up there with the little gun and his little dog and the geese. I love that. Okay, I'm going to keep with the Brenda Keys because I have two more. This is... this one might be a repeat. Did I say Town and Country Sampler? Did I put that in the wrong pile? I'm not sure. Sorry. If you saw it again, there you go. Get to see it again. Sorry. And then this one is Plymouth Sampler. Oh, there we go. Love it. So I loved her samplers. Went and bought more. The majority of these, let me make sure, I got from the Silver Needle. And they are online. They also, you can call them, but they're very easy to order online. So the Silver Needle, if you check that out, that's where I got most of these. Okay, I also got some other charts. Oh, wait a minute. I see some more Brenda Keys. So this is the Sailor's Wife sampler. I got two different orders here, so... And this one is Church on the Hill Sampler, which I love her churches. I just do. And this one is New England Sampler. Okay, since I'm totally obsessed and bought those all out, those don't have stickers on them. I thought I saved my invoice. Hold on, where did I get those from? If I find my invoice, I'll tell you where I got the other ones from, because I ordered from two separate companies. I think it's in this stack. I hope it's in this stack, but I don't know. I also got a book from Stash Unload, and when I bought it, I thought it was just the pattern on the front, which I would have been very pleased buying just that pattern. But it also has that pattern. And it also has, I won't show you the charts, it has all of these. So the one that I really, really love is Sleeping Beauty. Let me see if it'll focus on that. I love this one where she's in the woods, and I just need to kit that up because I really, really love it. So different. That was from Stash Unload. Okay, so I did get some more stuff from the Silver Needle. I got three stockings from Blackbird Designs. This is for December. There's one and two, three. I also got from Silver Creek Samplers, what is the name of this? Oh, Halloween Bright. And it said, Jack smiled so bright, he could be seen by everyone on Halloween. And you could put the year on there. Really love that. This one is 90 by 120, so it's not too big. I also got Down in the Valley by Blackbird Designs. You can see a theme that I was getting. I got Sweet Tulips by Blackbird Designs. I think this would be really pretty for the spring, but I won't be stitching it right now. I also got Morning Star from Blackbird Designs. Very cute, very simple. Oh, here's the other receipt that I got. Oh, nope, that's from Silver Needle. So maybe I did two orders from the Silver Needle. I thought I got another company. Maybe not, because they all have the Silver Needle on it. The Winter is Past from Blackbird Designs. Merrily, Merrily, We Welcome Spring by Blackbird Designs. Okay, now we're getting into something a little different. I got Ho 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 Santa Drum, and I don't think there's a picture that shows it all the way. I don't know that I'll do it as a drum, but it's really pretty. This is from Dames of the Needle. So I like that. This is Clean Dishes, and it says, Scary Cat, Salem Wishes, Need of a Spell to Clean My Dishes. Dames of the Needle. I thought that was cute. Really cute to put in the kitchen. You could leave that up year round too if you wanted to, because it's... This is actually on my to start list, so I want to kit this up pretty quick, and it's Midnight Watch from Blackbird Designs. I really, really, really love this. I'm a huge fall and Halloween fan to begin with, so these colors are right up my alley. So I have this set out that I'm going to be kitting up. The other one that I have from Dames of the Needle is Paul Revere Hornbook, and I really liked both of those patterns. So I love that. I don't know that I'll start this right away. This would go more with my Early American series, so I'll probably kit that up and then stick it in that bag. I got the third in the Magical Mystery Tour series, Blackbird Designs, and it's just called Blackbird. I think that's pretty. And then I have, what is this called? Spooky Boo, and it's from Silver Creek Samplers. It says, at first cock crow, the spirits go back to their resting. And then it says, I Ben Better is on the tombstone. I thought that was so cute. So I like that. Okay, I also got Patchwork Pumpkin from Blackbird Designs. So cute. And then I got Little House Needleworks Battle Hymn of the Republic. I think that would be really cute on my early American. This is a little bigger, so I don't know if I would put it in my dough bowl, but maybe do it as a flat fold finish and stick it behind everything. That would might be cute. Okay, I also got the Halloween copy of Cross Stitch, and I will tell you, I have gotten this in the past many times. There is more in this book than any other year that I have done. Now, somebody on one of the Cross Stitch groups talked about this pattern and about how there is some grammatical errors down here in the wording. And there is. When I first saw this, I wanted to do the pattern like this because I really like it. So if you cannot fix the grammatical errors down here, or if you look at it that he wrote it and he's not a very good writer, you can keep the grammatical errors. But anyhow, there's an option. It's a great pattern. There's an option. And maybe there's a reason why they have those grammatical errors. They use the wrong two in there, and then it says poor Jack Saunter is lying here too scared to run when Jack draw near. It should say draws near would be, but technically some of the older ones that might not be the case. So I don't know. If you don't like it, there is other options. That's all I'm saying. I wanted to point that out because it came up in a group. There's some really great patterns in here, and I wish I could show you more. Let me flip through here. I want to cover up the patterns. So these two are ones that I like. Like, I love that, and I love that witch. So, I don't want to show anybody's pattern. This is beautiful. Let me see if I can show this. I think they have it on another page. Yes. So I don't show you the pattern. Love that. Love that. So once again, there are other floss tubers that have gone through this magazine. Go check it out if you're curious. I think it's well worth a buy this year. I really, really do. I think they did an excellent job. Okay, I have one random one. Is Heartstring Samplery Farm and Folk Penny Cushions. And of course, I love them. They would go right in my dough bowl. Love them. Love them. All right, so I have several things. I want to start another sampler, and I haven't decided what sampler. So I kind of brought it over here. So Deb from Country Stitchers is stitching this one, which is G. Ledger 1898. She did a color change on it. I love her color change, but I decided to stick with the original. I was gonna use her color change, but I decided I really liked the colors. Once I pulled the colors and looked at them, I kind of liked them. So I do think I'm gonna keep them. I do like how they kind of blurred around the numbers, and I might do the same. So what Deb is doing is she is taking, like, as she drinks a cup of coffee, she takes a Q-tip and kind of like puts coffee dye in around the letters and to make it look more like the sampler. And I really like that idea. So I might do that, but with the original threads. I do have this kitted up. So that is one option. The next option is Luis Layer. I cannot say that word. 1901. And this one, a lot of people are starting on August 1st. So I kitted this one up in silks. I ordered it that way. My only problem, so when I looked at Deb's and she did a color conversion, I was like, oh, that would be awesome because I'm not crazy about this pink in the alphabet. But I did it in silks, so I'm afraid that I'll run out of floss if I do it differently. But what I was thinking about is taking the pink out of the alphabet and making it red flowers, because I think that would go better than the pink. I don't know. Something about the pink in the middle is bothering me. I don't know. Then I've showed this bill before, Oh Marie, and I really like this one. It's so pretty. I love it. That's on the contender. I want to start one of these. And then I got Louisa Barney 1892, and I love it too. I have not kitted this one up at all. So I'm going to choose one of those and hopefully start it this week. I also want to kit up my Blackbird. I also want to finish doing Farm Girl Fall. I want to stitch all the things. So that's my floss tube for 1 week. I'm sorry, I keep bumping the table, but I'm hitting the post down here because I try not to move my legs because my dogs are sleeping down there. But so that's it. That's all that I have this week. I don't know if I'll be back in a week or I'll be back in 2 weeks. I'm not sure, but enter the giveaways. You have a good chance of winning. If you want a giveaway, send me a message. If you're new here, like and subscribe. And thank you for joining me, and happy stitching, everyone.